From choking smog, rivers full of trash, and an enormous overpopulation issue, Beijing is working through a lot of issues. One is a bit more out there though. Beijing is sinking, and it is sinking as much as 4 inches every year, as found through satellite imagery and GPS data. Beijing isn't the only place to be experiencing this issue. Parts of California sunk as much as 2 feet between 2013 and 2016. Parts of Mexico City are sinking as much as 9 inches per year. And since the 1920s, part of the California San Joaquin Valley have sunk as much as 28 feet. So what is going on in all these places across the world, and why are cities such as Beijing sinking down into the ground? It all has to do with water and land subsidence. Due to the unsustainable exploitation and pumping of groundwater beneath the city's ground elevation has begun to sink. This is because the water is partly responsible for holding the ground up, which means with the billions of liters of water being pumped up from underneath the cities, they are over time sinking lower and lower. Here is a picture of the San Joaquin Valley in California showing the height of the land in 1925, 1955, and 1977, showing how much the ground in the valley has sunk due to subsidence. So what is land subsidence, and why is it causing cities to sink? Aquitards within aquifer systems are the main causation of land subsidence from groundwater pumping. An easy way to imagine this is if you were to haphazardly arrange dinner plates in your sink. This would have quite a bit of room in between them in which water can be stored. When the water is extracted, these sediments rearrange into stacks, which is similar to stacking your plates in a cupboard, meaning they have less space to store water and therefore occupy less space, seeing the ground lower. While the ground can recover from land subsidence caused by reversible elastic deformation, long-term pumping of groundwater causes the land surface to subside permanently. This greatly reduces the groundwater storage capacity due to the reduced space around the granular aquitard skeletons. In some places around the world, the ground is going down 10 times faster than water levels are rising, which is causing larger and longer floods in certain parts of the world. Just in the United States alone, 17,000 square miles across 45 states have been directly affected by land subsidence. The over-exploitation of underground water is causing many issues for the present and future generations. Sinking cities have a great effect on infrastructure and natural systems, such as gravity-driven water structures, which can be affected by even the smallest change of gradient. Damage to roads, railways, bridges, pipelines, buildings, and wells is also a major problem, with the effects already being very visible in many major cities. With sinking cities and land subsidence expected to cause trillions of dollars worth of damage in coming years, many parts of the world have a major problem to overcome. Thanks for watching, and be sure to subscribe.